In the morning, parts of Greenhill Point had been left in ruin. Windows were smashed out. Homes and stores had been vandalized. But more than anything else, there were smashed jack-o'-lanterns all over the city. No one had been seriously hurt, at least physically. But poor Mayor Alistair Jacobs would probably be needing therapy for at least the next few years. He'd been found duct-taped to his chair in City Hall, where the greatest brunt of the attack seemed to be focused. When asked who had done this to him, his response was simple. You wouldn't believe me if I told you. He would never speak about it again. The Greenhill Police Department had also had a busy night, responding to calls from panicked residents who reported everything from marionettes chasing people with flaming jack-o'-lanterns to marionettes piloting miniature prop airplanes, dropping said jack-o'-lanterns onto terrified onlookers fleeing for safety. Each time a police car made it to the scene, there was no trace of anyone or anything who could have done these things. Only the devastation of the attack left behind. Adding intrigue to this mystery was a further check on the residents of the Toymaker in the morning hours of November 1st, which found all 100 band of the misfit puppets present and accounted for this time, including Charlie Snaps. You will remember, gentle listeners, that Mr. Snaps had himself been noted as absent only 2 days before. Many of the misfits, however, were heavily disheveled, with traces of smoke, soot, and pumpkin fragments found on nearly all of them. In the years to come, this would all be explained away as merely one more element in what was obviously an elaborate prank, no doubt pulled off by more than one of the devoted fans of the Toymaker, who had decided to terrorize Greenhill Point in some demented tribute to the fallen puppet master. 1 year later, another devoted fan of the Toymaker was about to unveil a tribute to the man who had inspired him so much. It was now October 30th, 1966, the 1 year anniversary of his friend's passing. Carl Ellersby had acquired nearly all the Toymaker's creative assets by buying his estate. This, of course, included Charlie Snaps and his band of 100 misfits. Carl had spent much of the year designing and building a museum within Greenhill Manor, where guests would be able to get up close and personal with the work of the man who had inspired him so much. All 101 stars of the laboratory and no strings attached were lovingly displayed on a stage designed to be a perfect replica of the hit television show that had started it all. At the center of it was a brand new marionette, a puppet version of the Toymaker himself, designed by Ellersby's engineers and artists, standing proudly next to Charlie Snaps. A short time before the new museum was set to open, Carl was in the building all by himself. He enjoyed taking one final trip through his attractions before he opened them to the public for the first time. He took the opportunity to say a few words to the newest addition. "I think you'd approve of this museum," he said. "So long as I'm around, this building will celebrate your legacy, and generations will know about you and the genius you possessed. Enjoy the grand opening, old friend." Ellersby winked at the puppet.